Hi, welcome to History of Pharmacy video. First, we will discuss about pharmacy before the dawn of history. Ancient man learned from instinct, from observation of birds and beasts. Used materials in the surrounding like cool water, leaves, dirt or mud to stop bleeding and heal wounds. Dry clay was used to splint broken bones. Here is timeline for history of pharmacy from 2600 before Christ to 1500 before Christ. Next, we will discuss about history of pharmacy from 100 before Christ to 1200 Anno Domini. Now we discuss about pharmacy in ancient Babylon. Babylon, jewel of ancient Mesopotamia, the earliest known record of practice of the art of the apothecary when about 2600 before Christ. Babylonian healing practitioners combined the responsibilities of priest, physician and pharmacist. Medical texts on clay tablets record first the symptoms of illness, the prescription and directions for compounding, then an invocation to the gods. Next is pharmacy in ancient China. In ancient China, which is 2000 before Christ, legend tells that Emperor Shen Nung investigated the medical properties of hundreds of herbs. He recorded 365 native herbal drugs in the first Pan Cao, or also called the Great Herbal. Then, we talk about pharmacy in ancient Egypt, conducted by two or more echelons. Gatherers and preparers of drugs and chiefs of fabrication or head pharmacist. Next we talk about papyrus Ebers. About 2900 before Christ, Egyptian medicine was the best known, and most important pharmaceutical record is the papyrus Ebers during 1500 before Christ. A collection of 800 prescription mentioning 700 drugs. One of the most common remedies described in the papyrus is ochre, or medicinal clay, which was prescribed for intestinal and eyes complaint. Then, we discuss about Theophrastus, and he also known as father of botany. He was early Greek philosopher and natural scientist at about 300 before Christ. His observations and writings dealing with the medical qualities and peculiarities of herbs are unusually accurate, even in the light of present knowledge. Next, the royal toxicologist. Mithridates V was the king of Pontus, at about 100 before Christ, though, he battled Rome for all of time, found time to make not only the art of poisoning and also the art of preventing and counteracting poisoning. Unhesitatingly, he used himself as well as his prisoners as guinea pigs on which to test poisons and antidotes. His famed formula of alleged antidotal powers, Mithridatum. Next, Terra Sigillata. Terra Sigillata is also known as Sealed Earth, a clay tablet, originating on the Mediterranean island of Lemnos before 500 before Christ. Washed, refined, rolled to mass of proper thickness, the clay was formed into pastilles and impressed with an official seal by priestesses, then sundry. A scientist look at drug. In order to study materia medica, Dioscorides accompanied the Roman armies throughout the known world. He recorded what he observed, promulgated excellent rules for collection of drugs, their storage and use. His texts were considered basic science as late as the 16th century. Galen. Experimenter in drug compounding. Galen. From 130 AD to 200 AD practiced and taught both pharmacy and medicine in Rome. His principles of preparing and compounding medicine ruled in Western world for 1500 years. Class of pharmaceuticals compounded by mechanicals. Mean galenicals. He was the originator of the formula for a cold cream, essentially similar to that known today. Last is monastic pharmacy. During the Middle Ages, remnant of the Western knowledge of pharmacy and medicine were preserved in monasteries, from 5th century to 12th century. These scientists are known to have been taught in the cloisters as early as the 7th century. Manuscripts from many islands were translated or copied for monastery libraries.
Thank you for watching.